Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Sarisha, and today's practice is going to focus on binds. So I don't know about you, but I carry a lot of tension in my shoulders, and it makes it difficult for me to grab my hands back behind me. And if you are like me, then I encourage you to grab some props to help you with your practice today. If you've got a yoga strap, you can go ahead and grab that. Or if you've got anything that resembles a yoga strap, you can grab that. If you don't have a yoga strap, you can use a towel. And this is a hand towel, and you just need enough length so that you can hold the towel in one hand and grab the towel behind you with the other hand. So it kind of looks like this. Hopefully you can see. Yeah, you can see. So it kind of looks like this. So that's the pose that we're aiming for in our practice today. And so you might need a little bit longer of a towel, you might need a little bit shorter of a towel, but this is a great alternative if you don't have a yoga strap. And so the wonderful thing about binds is they help to bring fresh blood flow into different parts of the body. They're a great way to help release tension in the body and to help the muscles relax so that you can hold poses for longer and so that you can get into a deeper sensation of stretch and elongation in the muscles. And we're really going to be focusing on arm binds because of the shoulder tension that can occur, especially when we're tense or typing or anxious. So that's the benefit to doing binds and the focus for our practice today. So let's go ahead and get started. So you can set your props off to the side, whatever you're gonna be using to help you get that bind action. And we'll just come to a comfortable seated position. And you might shift your weight here from side to side so that you can feel your sit bones spread and root down into the ground below you. We'll close the eyes down and lengthen up through the spine. Sit back into yourself, stacking the shoulders over the hips. Take a deep inhale through your nose and exhale it out to your mouth. One more time like that. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Then exhale it out through your mouth. And starting to come into your breath. Notice the inhales and exhales, the pace and quality of your breath right now. Before making a conscious effort to lengthen out your inhales and smooth out your exhales. Feeling the breath move through your body, noticing the parts of your body that lift and expand as you fill up with air, and the parts of your body that soften down as you exhale out. Setting an intention for your practice today. Perhaps there's something that you've been working with, something that you've been thinking about lately. Message or mantra that you've been repeating to yourself. You can call that to mind right now, and I'll offer you this. You are whole and enough, just as you are right now in this moment. You are whole and enough just as you are right now in this moment. And remembering that wholeness within yourself as we move on our mat and even as you move off of your mat and into the rest of your day. We'll seal this intention by bringing the hands together in front of the heart center and taking a deep inhale through the nose and exhaling it out through the mouth. And when you're ready, we'll slowly blink open the eyes, lift the gaze. On an inhale, sweep your hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale, bring your hands together in front of your heart center.
One more time like that, inhaling, reaching up out of your waist, shifting the gaze up. Exhaling to bring your hands together in front of your heart center. Inhale, reach your hands back up toward the ceiling. And as you exhale, bring your right hand down, maybe about 6 inches away from your right thigh. Inhale here, grow tall, find length. Exhale, lean over towards the right. So you're getting into the left side body here. Soften through the shoulders, breathing here, draw your navel in to protect your low back, and feel your breath move through you. Take an inhale here. Take an exhale here. On an inhale, we'll come back up through center. So push into your right hand, reach your right hand up toward the ceiling to meet the left. As you exhale, bring that left hand down to your mat, maybe about 6 inches away from your thigh. Inhale to lengthen up. Exhale to lean over towards the left. Again, noticing where that right shoulder is and thinking about creating some distance from your right earlobe to your right shoulder. Draw your navel in and lean a little bit more towards the left, breathing into your right side body. Take an inhale here. Take an exhale here. Inhale, come back up through center. Exhale, release the hands down by your sides. We'll come to hands and knees now. So wrists underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. On an inhale, take your gaze up, send your seat up. As you exhale, round through your spine, gaze towards your navel. Inhale to shift your gaze forward, send your tail up. Exhale to round through your spine, gaze at your navel. Continue to move here with your cat-cow for two more rounds of breath. Breathing into your spine for this last round. And then we'll come back to neutral. We'll keep the left hand down on the mat, and on an inhale, we'll sweep the right hand up toward the ceiling, trying to open up through the front body. As you exhale, thread your right hand through so your right shoulder and your right ear come down towards the mat. You can choose to stay here, or you can walk the left hand towards the top edge of your mat. Breathing here. Noticing the shoulders and the sensations there, how your body is feeling today in this little twist. Then we'll bring the left hand back underneath the shoulder if you moved it. Press down into your left palm, inhale, sweep your right hand back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, bring your right hand down to the mat. Right hand stays down, inhale, sweep your left hand up toward the ceiling. Breathe here. Exhale, thread the left hand through so left shoulder and left ear comes down towards the mat. Stay here with the right hand underneath your right shoulder or start to walk your right hand towards the top edge of your mat, intensifying the sensation of twist here, breathing into that space between your shoulder blades. Noticing the sensations happening in the body today. Take an inhale here. Take an exhale here. Slowly start to walk your right hand back underneath your right shoulder. Press down into your right palm. Inhale, sweep the left hand up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bring the left hand down to your mat. Now from here, we're going to come down to the forearms. So you can grab opposite elbows here to just measure out the distance that you want to keep your elbows in. And that's in line with the shoulders. So there's one long line of energy here. And you can take your hands out into a number 11 so that your forearms and your hands are parallel. Or you can clasp your hands and just tuck one of your pinky fingers in so that you have like a nice base like this instead of your pinkies stacked on top of each other. So you'll pick your foundation and then we'll tuck the toes and send the hips up and toward the ceiling, finding a forearm downward facing dog or a dolphin pose. Now this might feel a little bit weird, but we're looking to engage through the forearms and notice the sensation in the shoulders. Take an inhale through your nose. Exhale it out through your mouth. Good. We'll bend through the knees, bring them back down to the ground, and we'll take a child's pose here. So knees can come closer together to stretch more into the low back, or knees can come further apart to stretch more into the hips. Arms towards the top edge of your mat, breathing here. You might move your forehead here from side to side, So you can release any tension in the brows, any tension around the third eye. Take one more round of breath here. Good, and we'll come back to hands and knees. And this time we'll tuck the toes and send the hips up and back, finding regular downward facing dog. And you might pedal it out here, bending one knee and then the other, nodding the head yes, shaking the head no. And knees can be bent a little or a lot. Heels can be way off the ground. You're going to press into your palms so you can seal up that energy there, creating that seal with your palms on the mat. Drawing energy from the ground to send your spine longer, your seat higher up toward the ceiling. Maybe shift your gaze, the space between your feet, maybe between your knees. Inhale, come onto your toes. Exhale, bend your knees, send your seat far back behind you, and then we'll walk the feet up to meet the hands, finding a forward fold, taking as much time as you need to find that forward fold. On an inhale, lift up halfway, think long spine. Exhale to fold it forward. One more time like that. Inhale, lift up halfway, long spine, shoulders draw away from your ears. Exhale, fold it forward. Root down into your feet, bend into your knees. We're going to slowly roll up to stand. Stacking one vertebrae at a time so that your head is the very last thing to come up. If you're lightheaded at all, do feel free to tuck your chin in like you're making a double chin. Feel the weight of your body rooting down into the feet, down into your mat. On an inhale, roll your shoulders up towards your ears. Exhale, soften them down by your sides. Two more rounds like that, inhaling, rolling up through the shoulders. Exhaling, softening them down. Last round. Good. On an inhale, sweep your hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale, cactus the arms here. Bend at the elbows. Open up across your chest. Draw your shoulder blades together on your back. Inhale, reach your hands back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, long spine. Exhale to fold. Step your right foot back to find a lunge. Bring your right knee down to the mat. Root down into your left foot and your right knee. And on an inhale, we're going to rise up nice and slow. Anjaneyasana. You pause, hands on your thigh, and settle in, noticing how your right hip is feeling. And then when you're ready, we'll reach both hands up toward the ceiling, drawing your navel in. And again, shoulders come down by your, down away from your ears, down by your back. Take an inhale here. Exhale, bring your hands down to frame your front foot. And we'll turn this into a half splits pose. So you'll start to walk your hands back to the back knee, and your left foot can stay on the mat, or you can come onto the left heel and flex your left toes towards your shin, any amount of bend in that left knee. And an inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, maybe start to bow forward ever so slightly. Thinking left hip back, right hip back, left hip forward. On an inhale, we'll re-bend the front knee, walk the hands forward. Tuck the back toes to lift your right knee off the mat and step back to a plank pose, top of a push-up. Knees can be up or down. Press into your palms, send your spine up toward the ceiling as you draw your navel in here for three. Fire up your breath here for two. Last round of breath here for one. On your exhale, send your hips up and back, find your downward facing dog. Take a deep inhale through your nose. Exhale, let it out to your mouth. Good, inhale, come onto your toes. Exhale, bend your knees and walk your feet up to meet your hands, finding your forward fold. Inhale to lift up halfway, think long spine. Exhale to fold. Press down into your feet. Inhale, rise up. Reach your hands all the way up toward the ceiling. Exhale, cactus the arms here. Bend at the elbows. Open up across your chest. Good. Inhale, sweep your hands back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, fold it forward. Come back down. Inhale, lift up halfway. Long spine. Exhale, fold it forward. Step your left toes back to find your lunge. We'll bring that left knee down to the mat. Toes can stay tucked or untucked. Press down into your right foot and your left knee. On an inhale, start to rise up. Anjaneyasana or low lunge. Maybe your hand's down your right thigh. And then once you've found your stance, you can send your hands up toward the ceiling. Softening shoulders down away from your ears. Draw your navel in. Find that subtle engagement here. Breathing here. Take an inhale here. Exhale, bring your hands down to frame your front foot. And we're gonna turn this into a half splits pose or Ardha Hanumanasana. So you'll start to walk your hands back towards that left knee. And maybe you come onto the right foot, the right heel, and flex your right toes towards your shin. And you might have to scoot that right heel a little bit forward to give yourself some length, so some room so you can lengthen through that right leg. The right knee can be bent a little or a lot. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, maybe you bow forward just a touch. Doesn't have to be a big forward fold here. And we're thinking right hip back, left hip forward. Take one more inhale here. One more exhale here. And as you inhale, we'll re-bend that front knee, walking the hands to frame your front foot. Tuck your back toes to lift your knee off the mat. Send your right toes to meet your left. Find your high plank pose. Take an inhale here. Exhale, lower all the way down to the mat with elbows pointing towards the back of the room. Untuck the toes to the tops of the feet, press down into the mat. Inhale, lift up cobra pose, pressing down into your toenails and drawing your shoulder blades together on your back. Exhale, lower down. One more time, just like that, press down into your feet, maybe so much so that your knees pop off the mat. And then inhale, lift up, finding your cobra pose, working your shoulder blades together, firming up through your core. Exhale, lower all the way down. Inhale, press up through hands and knees. Tuck your toes, send your hips up and back. Find your downward facing dog. Take a deep inhale here. Full exhale here. On an inhale, come onto your toes. Exhale, bend your knees and walk your feet up to meet your hands, finding your forward fold. Inhale, lift up halfway, think long spine. Exhale to fold. Press down into your feet. Inhale, rise up, reach your hands all the way up toward the ceiling. Exhale, cactus arms here, bend at the elbows. Open up across your chest, drawing your navel in. Inhale, reach your hands back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, release your hands down by your sides. So now we'll go ahead and locate whatever prop you're gonna be using here. So your strap or your towel. I'll use my towel. And we're gonna grab the hands at the low back. So you might test it out here. You might just go ahead and grab your hands, and if this feels comfortable for you, you can stick with this. If you need a little more space for your shoulders, if for your arm muscles, you can always grab hold of your towel or your strap instead. So I'm just gonna leave this handy towards the top of my mat, and you'll grab your palms, if you can grab your palms, and you'll keep the heels of your hand together at your low back. And then you'll start to send your knuckles down towards the mat. So the true tendency that we all have, because it's hard, is to allow the heels of the hands to open out. But I invite you to keep the heels of the hands, the whole palm, really sealed up. And then reach the knuckles down as you open up across your chest here. As you exhale, fold forward. So I let my hands come away from my low back. You might keep your hands at your low back, and you might experiment with which one feels more sustainable. Wherever you are, you're gonna work your shoulder blades together on your back because we're opening up across the front of the chest to get ready for the binds that we're gonna be doing. Draw your navel in. Let your head be heavy here. Take one more inhale here. One more exhale here. And then slowly release your clasp, bringing your hands down towards the mat. And you can circle your arms here, nothing fancy, literally just kind of encouraging some movement and blood flow, and you might change directions here. And then on inhale, we'll lift up halfway, long spine, exhale to fold. Step your right foot back to find your lunge. Root down into your feet, and on an inhale, we'll rise up, high lunge. So again, you can pause, hands at your thigh. And then when you're ready, send your hands up toward this ceiling, softening the shoulders down away from your ears. Spike that right heel up a little bit higher toward the ceiling. Now we'll find some movement here. As you exhale, we're gonna cactus the arms and bend that back knee so it's just hovering over the mat. Inhale, re-straighten, reach your hands up. That left knee is gonna stay bent. Two more times like that. Exhale, cactus the arms here, bend that back knee, let it hover above the mat. Inhale, re-straighten, re-stretch back up. Last round, press into your feet, bend here, draw your navel in, feel your strength. Inhale, straighten, reach back up. Good, exhale, lean forward, take your arms past your body, and we're gonna turn this into a warrior three. So you're gonna take as many hops as you need to lift the right toes off the mat and dial that right hip down in line with your left. Flex your right toes towards your shin, re-bend into that left knee, and tap your right toes back, coming back to your lunge. Inhale, sweep your hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale, bring your hands to your hips, bend your back heel down, finding warrior one. So you can widen out your stance a little bit here, you can shorten your stance, but those back right toes are gonna be at a 45 degree angle. So angled in instead of toes pointing out towards the long edge of your mat. Inhale, sweep your hands up toward the ceiling, warrior one. Now we're gonna find a bind. As you exhale, take your hands to clasp at your low back. Now, again, measure out your shoulder, see how you feel. You might grab hold of your towel instead, and you can grab on really far ends of the towel, or you can grab closer in to kind of measure out the width and distance that you've got in the flexibility of your shoulders. We'll keep that front knee bent. Inhale, reach your hands, your knuckles down towards the mat. Open up across your chest, draw your shoulder blades together on your back. Exhale, fold forward, any amount, humble warrior. Reaching your shoulders, your arms towards each other, maybe away from the low back. Allow your head to relax down towards the mat. Press into your feet, draw your navel in, take an inhale here. Take an exhale here. Good, press down into your feet. Inhale, come up, keep that bind. Now we're gonna spin onto the right toes, and send the right heel back up toward the ceiling. We're gonna revisit warrior three, but this time with a bind. Again, always an option to keep that towel or strap or to let it go and try it with just hands clasped. So taking as many hops as you need to be able to lift those right toes off the mat. Now notice if you're rounding down into your shoulders. Can you think about drawing your shoulder blades towards each other, away from the ground, towards the ceiling, draw your navel in. Keeping that bind, we're gonna bend the right knee, draw it forward, and then set it down. Release whatever strap you might be holding onto, and we're just gonna roll out the shoulders, shake out the hands, crack the knuckles, crack the toes, and let go of whatever just happened on that first side. On an inhale, sweep your hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, think long spine. Exhale, fold it forward. Step your left toes back to find your lunge. Press down into your feet, inhale, start to rise up, finding your high lunge. Maybe you pause for a moment. Hands on the top of your thigh before you stand, find your steady stance, and then send your hands up toward the ceiling. Spike up on that left, spike that left heel up toward the ceiling. Press down into your feet, soften your shoulders down away from your ears, and we're gonna find that movement again. So taking an inhale here. Exhale, cactus the arms, bend that back knee to hover above the mat. Good, inhale, re-straighten. Keep that right knee bent. Exhale, bend the knees, bend the elbows. Keep your lower ribs knitted in. Inhale, re-straighten, reach back up. Last round like this. Exhale, bend the elbows, bend that back knee, let it hover, find your strength. Inhale, re-straighten, reach your hands back up. Good, exhale, lean forward, take your arms past your body, and now take as many hops as you need to find your warrior three on this side. So that left hip is trying to dial in line with your right. You're flexing your left toes towards your shin. You're thinking one long line of energy from the crown of your head to that back heel. And then we're gonna bend into that front knee, tap the left toes down, find your high lunge again. Exhale, bring your hands to your hips, spin that back heel down, find your warrior one on this side. So I like to widen my stance. You can shorten your stance. Just make sure those left toes are not pointing to the long edge of your mat. They're angled in slightly. So we'll bend into that front knee. Inhale, sweep your hands up. Find your warrior one pose. Feel your strength. Root down into your feet. Soften through your shoulders. Good, now we're gonna take humble warrior here. So you can use your towel or your strap, or you can try it without any props. But this, if you're taking the hands to clasp, try the opposite thumb on top. I'm gonna use my towel again. And I'm gonna keep my hands closer together because this is gonna challenge the sensation of stretch for me. It might be different for you. Keep that front knee bent. Inhale, reach your knuckles down towards the ground. Open across the front of your chest, but keep your lower ribs knitted in. And then exhale, fold it forward. Humble warrior. Maybe the right shoulder rests on the right knee. Maybe the right shoulder comes on the inside of your right knee. Draw your navel in. Draw your shoulder blades together on your back. Feel that engagement with your feet and the ground below you. Find your breath. Good, we're down into your feet. Inhale, come up. Keep the mind if you can. Know you can always let go if you need to. Spike onto the left toes, and we're gonna take a bound warrior three. So taking as many hops as you need, because now that the arms are bound, it takes a little more effort to find that balance. Draw your navel in. Draw your knuckles towards that left heel. Flex your left toes towards your shin. Think cobra pose in your back, drawing shoulder blades together. Take one more inhale here. Exhale, start to draw the left knee forward, setting left toes down. Release any clasp or bind you might have. And then we'll roll out the shoulders. We'll shake out the wrists. We'll crack the toes and feel the heat. So we'll press into the feet, and we'll bring the hands onto the heart. Maybe left hand on the heart first, right hand on top of the left. We'll close the eyes down. And take a moment to feel your heartbeat in your chest. And feel your breath moving through your body. A reminder of your wholeness, of your strength. Slowly blink open the eyes, and we'll come back to face the top edge of your mat if you're facing a different direction. Notice the leg muscles working. Inhale, sweep the hands up toward the ceiling. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, lift a pathway, think long spine. Exhale to fold. Plant your hands and step back to your plank pose, top of a push-up. Inhale here. Exhale, lower all the way or halfway down. Inhale to come up for cobra pose or upward facing dog if you are ready. Exhale to make your way back through hands and knees or push straight back to your downward facing dog. Pressing down into your palms and your feet, take a deep inhale through your nose. Exhale it out through your mouth. Good. You might draw the left foot closer towards midline. On an inhale, reach that right leg up and back behind you. Bend your knees, stack your hips here, opening up. Keep drawing your navel in. And you might draw circles here with your right knee. You might just simply roll the right ankle. Keep pressing into your feet so your torso is square towards the mat. And then we'll straighten that right leg square off the hip. As you exhale, draw your right knee in towards your nose. Shift forward and step the right foot up in between your hands. Come onto the ball mound of your left foot. Strongly here, and on an inhale, rise up. High lunge. Take an inhale here. Exhale, spin it out. Warrior two. Front heel and back arch are in one long line. Take up space here. Flip your front palm up. Exhale, reverse warrior, tipping it back. Left hand to the back of your left thigh, or maybe you go for the half bind. Left arm around your low back, front knee stays bent. Breathe here. Inhale, come back to your warrior two. Exhale, side angle pose. So right forearm to right thigh. Left hand up toward the ceiling or over the ear towards the front of the room. Draw your navel in. Maybe you experiment with taking a half bind here, taking that left arm back around the low back here. thinking about opening your torso towards the left, draw your navel in. Inhale, come back to your warrior two pose. As you exhale, windmill your hands down to frame your front foot, spinning onto those back toes. Step your right toes back to meet your left and flow, inhaling here. Exhaling to lower all the way or halfway down. Inhaling to come up for cobra pose or upward facing dog. Exhaling to make your way back to your downward facing dog. Finding your breath here, taking a deep inhale through your nose. Exhaling it out through your mouth. You might bring that right foot a little closer towards midline. Press down into your right foot, inhale, sweep the left foot back. Bend the left knee, stack the hips here, opening up. Keep pressing into your hands so that your torso is square towards your mat. And you might draw circles here with your left knee. You might roll the left ankle. Noticing how left hip feels today. And then we'll straighten the left leg, square off the hips, and as you exhale, draw your left knee in towards your nose, shift forward, and step your left foot up in between your hands. Press down into your feet. Inhale, start to rise up. High lunge, take your time. Take an inhale here. Exhale, spin it out. Warrior two. Front heel, back arch are in one long line. Flip your front palm up. Exhale, reverse warrior, tipping it back. Keep that front knee bent. The right hand can rest on the back of your right thigh, or maybe you take the right arm around the low back for the half bind. Reaching the left hand far back behind you. Inhale, come back to your warrior two pose. As you exhale, find your side angle pose. Left forearm to left thigh, right hand up toward the ceiling or over the ear towards the front of the room. If you'd like to experiment with a bind again, you might take that right arm around the low back here. Take a deep breath here. Spinning your torso open towards the right. Press down into your feet, inhale, come back to your warrior two. As you exhale, windmill your hands down, framing your front foot, spinning onto the back toes, and we'll step the right foot up to meet the left, finding your forward fold. Inhale, lift up halfway, think long spine. Exhale to fold. Press down into your feet, inhale, rise up, sweep your hands all the way up toward the ceiling. Exhale, cactus, the arms here bend at the elbows, open up across your chest. Inhale, reach the hands back up toward the ceiling. Exhale, fold it forward. Inhale, lift up halfway, long spine. Exhale to fold. Step your left foot back to find your lunge. Press down into your feet, inhale, rise up, high lunge. Exhale, spin it up. Warrior two. Flip your front palm up. Exhale, reverse warrior. Maybe go straight into the bind. Keep that right hand around your low, keep your left hand around your low back with that bind, and we're finding our side angle pose. Right forearm to right thigh. Left arm still around the low back. Now maybe you find your towel, your strap. Maybe you don't need it. But we're gonna use this so that we can grab hold and have the bind here. So you'll reach that right hand underneath the right leg so that you can grab hold of your towel. Now notice if you're spinning your sternum down towards the ground, think about opening your chest towards the right, pressing into your feet, even if that means you've got to open your hands longer to the either ends of your towel. Press down into your feet, root into your core, draw your navel in. Slowly release the clasp, bringing the towel back down to the mat. Inhale, come back to your warrior two pose. Good, exhale, windmill your hands down to frame your front foot, spinning onto those back toes. Step your right foot back to meet your left and move through your flow. Inhaling here, exhaling to lower all the way or halfway down. Inhaling to come up for cobra pose or upward facing dog. Exhaling to make your way back to your downward facing dog. Take a deep inhale here. Full exhale here. Inhale, come onto your toes. Exhale, bend your knees and walk your feet up to meet your hands at the top of your mat, finding your forward fold. Inhale to lift up halfway, long spine. Exhale to fold. We're gonna step the right foot back to find the lunge. Press down into your feet, inhale, rise up. High lunge. Inhale here. Exhale, spin it out. Warrior two. Flip your front palm up. Exhale, reverse warrior. Taking the right arm around the low back for the bun. Inhale here. Exhale, come to your bound side angle pose. So left forearm to the top of your left thigh. Right hand stays around the low back. Now you can choose to stay here or you can choose to experiment with the bun, grabbing hold of your towel, looping it through. So your left hand comes underneath, the left arm comes underneath the left leg, and you're grabbing hold of the towel behind you. You might have to shorten your stance here. Now notice if your sternum, your chest is towards the ground, and think about opening it up. Noticing your balance. Opening it up towards the left, maybe even up toward the ceiling. Notice your breath. Slowly release the clasp, releasing the towel. Inhale, come back to your warrior two. Exhale, windmill your hands down to frame your front foot, spinning onto those back toes. Step back to your plank pose, moving through one last flow, or skip it while knee in downward facing dog. Moving with your breath, moving at your pace. Take a deep inhale here. Full exhale here. Slowly bring your knees down to the mat and we'll find a quick child's pose for just two rounds of breath. If you've got any tension in the shoulders, you can bring your arms down by your sides, fingertips towards the back edge of your mat. Coming back to your intention, remembering that you are whole and enough, just as you are right now in this moment. Slowly press back up, and we're gonna work on our peak pose for class, which is cow face pose or Gomukhasana. So it involves hips and arms, and you can choose to do both or none, or one or the other. So what you can keep your arm, you can keep your legs in a cross-legged seated position, or you can keep the left foot, left leg on the bottom, and draw the left heel towards your right seat. And then you can place your right foot in front of your left knee, or cross it over so that your right knee is lifted, or maybe your hips are open enough to stack your right knee on top of your left. Now this might be a lot, and if at any point in time this feels unsustainable, you can release this aspect of the pose and just come to a cross-legged seat. Now you'll grab hold of your towel or your strap, or perhaps your shoulders are feeling open enough here. But we'll take the towel in the left hand, and we'll allow the towel to hang back so the left elbow is up toward the ceiling. Now you can take this in stages and the right hand can come to rest on the left elbow and you can just experiment with this. Now notice if you're crouching in and your neck is rounded, think about lifting the crown of your head up toward the ceiling so that your neck is long and straight. You can choose to stay here or you can take the right hand out like your back of your hand is facing forward, your thumb is down, and then you'll sneak that hand back behind you so your palm is out and you can grab the towel or strap. So you're finding length here, you're drawing your shoulder blades down your back, you're breathing here, and acknowledging that this pose is a lot. You can choose to stay upright, or maybe you can start to fold forward. Any amount. Take two rounds of breath here. Last round. And we'll slowly release the clasp, slowly opening the shoulders out. You might take your hands down to the mat and do a couple of shoulder rolls here. You might move the head from side to side. And then we'll just uncross the legs, take the legs out long. You might bump the knees, swish the feet, and we'll come to the second side. So you'll bring your right leg down on the bottom. The right heel will start to come towards the left seat. And you can choose to stay here. Maybe the left leg is long. Maybe the left foot is in front of the right knee. Maybe you can cross the left foot over and it comes to the outside of the right knee. Make sure that left sit bone is rooting down. Or maybe you can stack your knees on top of each other. And now this is a lot, so take a moment to check in and see if this is where you need to stay or if you need to soften the legs portion of this pose. Now we'll take the towel in the right hand and we'll allow the right hand to come back behind the back of your neck, right elbow up toward the ceiling. Your left hand can come to just rest on top of that right elbow, and this can be a perfectly great place to stop, to just check in, to breathe. Keeping the crown of the head reaching tall so you're not crouching in, you're lengthening up, you're drawing your navel in. And if you want to experiment with the bind, then you'll take your left hand out towards the left, back of the hand facing forward, left thumb down towards the mat, and then you'll bend your elbow and take the left hand back behind you so you can grab the bottom of your strap or your towel. Maybe you think about drawing your hands closer together if you're looking for a challenge, but give yourself space to have your hands far away from each other. Well, that's what the towel or the strap is for. You'll lengthen up again. Make sure you've got a long spine. Draw your navel in and breathe here for 3 rounds of breath. Choosing to stay upright or maybe to bow forward, it's up to you. This is your practice. Last round of breath. Slowly, with control, you'll release the grasp that you have on the towel. Take your arms out, maybe out to your sides, and roll out the shoulders a little bit here. Maybe send your gaze side to side. And then we'll straighten out the legs. And we'll windshield wiper the knees here from side, the feet here from side to side. Maybe bump the knees. And then from here, we'll come to lay down on the back and we'll keep the knees bent. We'll take the arms out into a T shape or a cactus shape if you don't have the room. And we'll heel toe the feet toward the edges of the mat. On an exhale, you'll allow your knees to knock over towards the left. So it's perfectly fine if knees are hovering here. My knees are nowhere near the ground. But we're going for a sense of twist and a sense of stretch along the right side body. Take 2 more rounds of breath here. Inhale, come back through center. Exhale, take it over to the other side, allowing the knees to knock over towards the right. Getting the sense of twist and the stretch in the left side body here. Softening through the muscles of the face. Take 1 more round of breath here. And we'll come back through center when you're ready. Keeping the feet as wide as the mat. We'll allow the knees to knock in towards each other so the low back comes down into the mat. Hands can stay out, or maybe you bring your hands to the body. And we'll just pause here for a moment of rest. Allowing the breath to soften and release to come back to normal. Softening the muscles of the body, especially the muscles of the face around the jaw. Calling to mind the intention that you might have set at the start of class. Good. When you're ready, we'll slowly start to wiggle fingers and toes, all ankles and wrists. Crack the toes, move the head from side to side. We'll draw the knees in towards the chest, giving yourself a squeeze, maybe even drawing your forehead up towards your knees. And then relaxing the head down, we'll roll over onto one side and pause. Noticing how you feel now as compared to the start of class. When you're ready, no rush, we'll start to press ourselves up to a comfortable seated position. With the eyes closed or the gaze downward to keep the focus inward. You might shift your seat here from side to side, so sit bones root down and we'll lengthen up through the spine, stacking shoulders over hips, gathering the hands together in front of the heart center, bow the head. Remembering that you are whole and enough, just as you are right now in this moment. When you're ready, you can slowly blink open the eyes and lift the gaze. The light in me honors and bows to the light in each one of you. And so we say, Namaste. Thank you all so much for sharing your practice with me. If you enjoyed this practice, let me know in the comments below. Hit the subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks.